By for us in Pretoria. Now, Lady, very interesting representations made there by Mr. Kingung. Did the commissioner elaborate how SARS found itself in this situation?
Yes, good afternoon, Nompu. The acting commissioner, Mr. Mark Kinton, elaborated that there was absolutely no need to have begun with the new operating model in 2014 because the old one worked perfectly well. He said that currently SARS has lost its credibility and they are always in the news for all the wrong reasons. He says that they're trying to work hard to restore the credibility at SARS. He says that he's aware that cameras have been planted everywhere at SARS, and this has actually created an element of fear. But the question is that he's only got 2 months in the job. Will he be able to achieve all these targets that he has set out to achieve within a short period of time?
The commission posed to Mr. Kingung that should they decide to rule that the consulting companies that took money from SARS, should they rule that those money should be sent back to SARS, what would Mr. Kingung do with them? He had a lot of plans. Just tell us what he said.
Yes, he says that this money will actually come in handy, especially for the IT department, which actually needs to upgrade its equipment. So he's going to definitely use that money towards that. He says that the other money will be utilized towards staff morale and to actually train staff so that they can be more efficient, so that they can be able to set the revenue targets that they want to achieve for this year.
Interestingly enough, it was interesting that Judge Nugent reminded him that he's only an acting commissioner, that obviously SARS still has a residing permanent commissioner. That was an interesting observation on my part. But I understand that he also gave an unreserved apology. What were the contents of that apology?
Yes, the acting commissioner actually apologized to the president and also to the members of the public and also to the employees of SARS and those who've been perched, to say that he apologized for not upholding the SARS venues, and he wants to be held responsible for that and everybody else who's in charge, and that for not doing enough to correct all the wrongs that were done at SARS.
And then there's a story about one of the SARS employees using taxpayers' monies to make legal representations at the commission. Tell us about that.
Yes, one of the executives, Mr. Luther Lobelo, who's actually a group executive for employee relations, spent about 759,000 rand in 1 month for legal representation at the inquiry. And then the judge was said this is absolutely was not necessary. He asked the commissioner how come he allowed this to happen, but the commissioner said this is the first time that he heard of something like that, because the person who actually authorized this payment was the head of legal, and he's going to undertake an investigation to get thorough information of what actually happened there. Apparently Mr. Luther Lubelo, his intention was actually to discredit the existence of the so-called rogue unit. He wanted to show that this rogue unit did at some stage exist and they actually were doing things that were illegal.
So, Naledi, interestingly enough, from the information that you've given us here, you've indicated that indeed they're going to be bringing back some of those units that were disbanded. Just elaborate on that.
Yes, they've mentioned that they want to bring back the illicit economy unit, which was dealing with tobacco smuggling and also rhino poaching. They also want to bring back the large business center, which will be effect from April next year.
Thanks very much, Naledi, for that report. That was my colleague Naledi Matlepeng reporting from the SARS inquiry.